Hello class, today we will start the further subtopic from the chapter Women Change the World. Before starting the chapter, let's come on the recap whatever we studied in the last class. The subtopic is schooling and education today. In the last class, we studied about Rokeya Sakhawat Hussain. She wanted to study Bangla and English, but she was not permitted, but she got the support of her elder brother and elder sister, and she learnt English and Bangla. In that time, English was understood the language of British, that would expose the girls, but she learnt English and she write her first story. The story name is Sultana's Dream in 1905. Understand? We have read this. Afterward, the next character is Ras Sundari Devi. She belongs to West Bengal. She belonged to a rich landlord family. In the age of 60, she learned read and write. And she was not getting the chance to read and write, but she stole the manuscript from the holy book that was read by her husband. She took one page from Chaitanya Bhagavat, the story of a saint, from that book, and she also took one page from her Sun book, alphabet book, and she was matching, and after great labor she learnt a lot about the language. Understand? Afterward we will read the subtopics in the chapter. So students, please be serious and pay attentive and enjoy your lecture. Students, the subtopics which we will study in this class, the subtopics are women's movement, campaigning, raising awareness, protesting, showing solidarity. These are the subtopics which we will discuss here. First, start the subtopic women's movement. Students, you know that women and girls now have the right to study and go to school. But in the earlier time, it was difficult for them to get education. But in the other fields, spheres like legal reform, violence and health, where the situation of women and girls has improved. And these changes have not happened automatically. This is a long, strong conflict. We can say that it is a struggle. This struggle is known as women's movement. And in this movement, women collectively and individually, they fought against the corruption, fought against the discrimination, whatever had been happened with them in the earlier time, and now in this time they also struggle for getting equality, equal opportunity. Understand? Students, you know that the diversity, passion and efforts of those who involved makes it a very vibrant movement, women's movement. Different strategies have been used to spread awareness, to fight against discrimination and seek justice. Understand? Means that women tried a lot to get justice and they struggled for increasing awareness among women. The next subtopic is campaigning. Students, women campaigning, they fought against discrimination and violence against women are an important part of women's movement. Understand? Campaigns have also led to new law being passed, and law was passed in 2006, and this law was against domestic violence, where women were treated, or women are treated today physically, they are treated badly in, we can say that in physical way or in mental way, where the women are treated badly. The law has been passed by the constitution that women must not be treated badly at home or any working place. Understand? Domestic violence where women were treated badly in 2006. Afterward, we know that in 1997, there was a law by the Supreme Court that women must not be assaulted. They must not face sexual harassment in working place as well as at any public places or any places, all the workplaces and especially in the educational institutions. Understand? It has been abolished by the law. Understand? Afterward, we are coming in 1980, women protested against dowry, where women were treated badly, girls were treated badly because of dowry. They were killed by their in-laws or by their husband because of dowry. So women also protested against dowry system. The dowry system, they increased awareness among women. They started to campaign on road, they started to protest. Understand? They went to the court to find justice. So afterward, what had happened? The matter has been increased, and the matter had been published and started to be published in the magazine, and it has become a public issue. And in 1980s, during that time, the government has passed the rule that if anyone will take dowry or anyone who will give the dowry, both of the parties will be punished, will get punishment, and it is abolished by the law. Understand? It will become in the category of crime. Understand? The next subtopic is raising awareness. In raising awareness, women also started to raise awareness among public for getting their rights. Their message has been spread through street plays by on the street with plays, with street plays, songs and public meetings. Understand? They started to increase awareness so that their rights must be recognized by the government. Next subtopic is protesting. You know that the women movement raises its voice when violations against women takes place. Understand? For example, which type of violence had taken place are happening today? When a law or policy acts against their interest, when any law will be made against their interest and their interest and against their desires, public rallies and demonstrations are a very powerful way of drawing attention to injustice. So we can say that how women started to protest and today they protest to create awareness so that nothing will happen against their interest. They started to, in the earlier time, during 1980s, they started to protest in form of demonstration, taking out rallies, understand? Signature campaign, there are a lot of way, by these way they started to go against their right, whatever had happened against to them, understand? The next subtopic is, showing solidarity. In this subtopic, we will know that women also, they work for their rights individually and collectively. They went against the government if anything had happened against their interest. Understand? Students, you know that on 8th March every year, we celebrate International Women's Day. Understand? International Women's Day is celebrated throughout the world so that it will show the power of women and it will increase awareness among them so that they can make a better place in the society and they can make their position prominent in the society. Understand? So I hope that you have understood all these subtopics clearly. Thanks for watching the video.